So I told you to plot a graph for A1. Have you plotted the graph for A1? Time and distance you were supposed to plot. And what conclusion can you draw about the acceleration? Is it constant, increasing, decreasing, or zero? What about the forces acting on the object? Yes. Show the graph. What is the shape of the graph? What? Then what did you say? That you have graph, empty graph paper. What do you have to do with empty graph paper? Kya kare yahan laga do? Graph paper laga do yahan. Yes, who else has plotted? I told you to do this. So you haven't. Why? Scale nahi pata chal raha kisko? हाँ, it is going up to 343, starting from 1 means 0. 0 से 343 तक जा रहा है, तो you can take big intervals. Actually, ये cubes की form में vary कर रहा है. If you notice the pattern is 1 cube, 2 cube, 3 cube, 4 cube, 5 cube, 6 cube and 7 cube. It's going like that. So pattern आपका 7 cube तक जा रहा है, that is the reason. So acceleration is increasing, decreasing. No, it is not decreasing. Distance is increasing. So velocity will also be, and acceleration will also be increasing in this case. When you will plot the graph, you will come to me. And what do you infer about the forces? Forces will be unbalanced. So that's why motion is being paused. A2 we have to do. A2 to nahi kiya abhi humne. Two persons managed to push a motor car of mass 1200 kg at a uniform velocity along a level road. Motor car, the mass of motor car is 1200 kilograms. The same motor car can be pushed by three persons to produce an acceleration of 0.2 meter per second square. Acceleration is this much, required is this much. With what force does each person push the motor car? So F is equal to ma, very simple. We will use F is equal to ma. This will give us total force exerted by all the people together, all the three persons together. Okay? Ye total force aa gaya. So you will divide it by three. You will divide it by three now. Kyunki ye total force hai. So 240 Newton is the total force. Force exerted by one person. By each person is divided by 380 newton. 80 newton. So that is 80 newton. Many of you are not having NCERT also. It's in the bag. Very good. What's the use? Bag ka kya karna? So I hope that is clear. Any doubt you can ask. A3 now. A hammer of mass 500 gram. Yes. A3. A hammer of mass 500 gram moving at a speed 50 meter per second. Mass and speed strikes a nail. The nail stops the hammer in a very short time of 0.01 second. So initial velocity was u and final velocity zero. Hammer stops. What is the force of the nail on the hammer? तो कौन सा फॉर्मूला है जिसमें सब आते हैं? विच फॉर्मूला? सेकेंड लॉ. F is equal to ma and put the formula of a also in the same. So we have all the things together. M, V, U, T and F, U. So directly we can use this formula. हाँ ऐसे भी कर सकते हैं. Mass should be in kilogram divide by 1000. So half kg is the mass. V is 0, U is 50, time is 0.01. Half into minus 50 into 100. Okay, so this is minus 2500 newton. ये तो आ गया आपका force. Who was asking impulse? Impulse को नहीं पूछी हुई यहाँ पे. Impulse is otherwise product of force and time. Impulse is F into T, force into time. You want to calculate impulse here in this question? But they are not asking impulse. In which question? तो आप इंपल्स से करना चाहते हो? नो नीड, गो बाय द इजी वे. लेट्स सी द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. एनी डाउट इन दिस क्वेश्चन? क्लियर? A4, लास्ट क्वेश्चन. अ मोटर कार ऑफ मास 1200 केजी इज मूविंग अलोंग अ स्ट्रेट लाइन विद यूनिफॉर्म वेलोसिटी ऑफ 90 किलोमीटर पर आवर. Its velocity, that was u. Its velocity is slowed down to 18 km per hour, this is v, in 4 seconds by an unbalanced external force. Calculate the acceleration and change in momentum. Also calculate magnitude of force. So we have to find three things. Acceleration, force, change in momentum, wo sab to aise ho jayega. Theek hai, impulse is equal to change in momentum. Note kar lo if you want. So let me note down the data first. A4. A motor car of mass 1200 kilograms is moving along a straight line with U 90 and V 18 and time is 4 seconds. We have to find acceleration, force and change in momentum. So first task is to convert velocities into meter per second, multiply with 5 by 18. 1 kilometer per hour is 5 by 18 meter per second. तो ये आ गया आपका 25 एंड दिस इज 10. हाँ जी, हाँ ये 18 है, ये आ गया 5. तो अब फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल फाइंड एक्सेलरेशन, देन फाइंड एफ, देन फाइंड फाइनल माइनस इनिशियल मोमेंटम M V minus U. That's it. Okay, you need to know the formula only, then you can solve. So after writing the values, you must check the units first of all. If your units are not proper, your answers will be wrong. Whole question will be wrong. So agar units aapne dhyan nahi diya, mass sometimes it is in gram, velocity is in kilometer per hour, you have to convert into the SI unit. That's why for doing motion chapter, we spent a lot of time in understanding the units first of all. Otherwise, your chapter was starting from directly motion at rest and object at rest or in motion and point object and scalar vector quantity. But we started from fundamental and derived quantity so that you get knowledge about the units first. Because units are very important in physics. If you don't care of take care of units, you can't do numerical. Okay. So now our syllabus is over, and if you have any doubts, you can ask from this chapter. Next week we'll be doing the revision of numericals, practice of numericals only, and your exams next month will be MCQs only. The pattern will be MCQs, but don't think so that only MCQs are always there. MCQs will also be of different type, assertion, reason type. More than one option is correct. Complicated, complex MCQs like that. Case study type questions like that. So ये नहीं होगा कि एक-एक टिक करते जाओ तो क्या मारते जाओ तो पेपर हो जाएगा, ऐसे नहीं है. केजी मीटर पर सेकंड. Change in momentum means momentum. तो यूनिट विल बी केजी मीटर पर सेकंड. अगर आंसर के साथ यूनिट नहीं लिखते हो, हाफ मार्क विल बी डिडक्टेड. इन ईच केस हाफ मार्क विल बी डिडक्टेड. यस तन्वीन.
मैम आई वांट टू आस्क कि मैम जो हमारे टर्म वन का सिलेबस है और जो हमारे सितंबर वाले पेपर का सिलेबस है वो सेम है?
वी लेट यू नो. पहले सितंबर वाले का तो यही है, आप नोट कर लो. ठीक है, टू चैप्टर्स मोशन एंड फोर्स. यस जब जी. यस स्पीक अप.
मैम जो हमारा टेस्ट हुआ.
हाँ जी, एनी अदर डाउट, एनी अदर डाउट स्टूडेंट. ओके सो राइट वन क्वेश्चन नाउ. लेट अस डू सम एक्स्ट्रा क्वेश्चंस. राइट डाउन वन क्वेश्चन. यस यस यस. व्हाट हैपेंड, किसका मोमेंटम का ये लिख तो दिया मैंने. सिंपल तो एम एम इनटू वी. Yes, write down. Two objects, one lighter and the other heavier. Two objects, one lighter and the other heavier have the same momentum. Have the same momentum. Two objects, one lighter and one heavier, have the same momentum. Which of them is moving faster? Which of them is moving faster? We have to prove it. Mathematically, we will prove this using only the Ohm's law of momentum. Okay, using only the formula of momentum, we can do that. So we have a lighter object. Let us say its mass is small m, and heavier. Let us say its mass is capital M. Yeah, आप m1 m2 भी ले सकते हो. हाँ, let करो. So momenta are same. Momentum of smaller object is equal to momentum of heavier object. Capital P कर लो. ठीक है. So, what is the momentum of lighter object mv? What is the momentum of heavier object mv? Okay. So from here, what is the ratio of their velocities? You can write like this. Likh sakte hain aise? Is this step clear?
Check. Capital mv check.
Because product of small mv is equal to product of capital M. So if you want to write the ratio of velocities, so it will be reverse. Now we know capital M is greater than small m. Heavier mass ज़्यादा है lighter से. So इसको denominator में ले जाइए. M by m is greater than one. That means, so if this is greater than one, this should also be greater than one. If this is greater than one, this should also be greater than one. रेशो ऐसे वेरी करती है, मैथ्स में करते हो. सो बिकॉज एम ओवर एम इज ग्रेटर देन वन, देयरफॉर वी ओवर वी इज ग्रेटर देन वन. सो स्मॉल वी इज ग्रेटर देन कैपिटल वी. सो द स्मॉलर ऑब्जेक्ट हैज मोर वेलोसिटी, इट इज फास्टर. So the object is answer is lighter object will be faster, its velocity will be more. Lighter object will be traveling faster, its speed will be more. Dekha to jaye wo to theek hai, par aapko samjhana padega. So now you have proved it. Write another question now. Why are the tires of a vehicle circular? Why are the tires of a vehicle circular? How friction is reduced? Yes, because if we take the circular tires, rolling friction will be there. Other than any other shape, if you take a triangular tire, square shape tires, ठीक है, सभी में friction sliding होगा. But if you take circular shape, then the friction will be rolling. And rolling friction is always less than sliding friction. हाँ, तो वो vehicle smoothly move करेंगे road पे. अगर हम square tires ले ले, तो उनका move करना बहुत difficult हो जाएगा. Lot of fuel will be consumed in overcoming that large sliding friction. But this, is that clear? Write another question now. वो करवाया था आपको मैंने, एयर एज लुब्रिकेंट, वो लिखो. कैन एयर एक्ट एज अ लुब्रिकेंट? कैन एवर एयर एक्ट एज अ लुब्रिकेंट? कैन यू गिव एन एग्जाम्पल वेर यू हैव सीन दैट एयर कुशन हेल्प्स इन मूविंग द ऑब्जेक्ट फास्टर? कहाँ देखा है इसमें? हूवरक्राफ्ट में. इट्स अ टैंक टाइप स्ट्रक्चर, टैंक टाइप व्हीकल विद अ लार्ज ब्लैडर, ब्लैक कलर्ड ब्लैडर एट द बॉटम. देखा होगा टीवी पे आपने. सो इट रन्स वेरी फास्ट because it doesn't touch the ground, it forms a layer of air between the ground and the bladder. So that air cushion acts like a lubricant, and the lubricants, you know, they reduce the friction. So friction is reduced to a great extent, and that's why it's able to move, it's able to run very fast. So hovercraft mein air also acts as a lubricant. You can write the cushion of air, likho cushion of air formed between, cushion of air formed between the ground and the bladder, between the ground and the bladder acts as a lubricant and reduces friction. Ground and the bladder acts as a lubricant and reduces friction. Next question is, fully inflated tires, fully inflated tires help in saving fuel. Comment. Fully inflated tires help in saving fuel. Explain. पूरे अगर एयर कम होती ना आपके व्हीकल के टायर्स में, तो फ्यूल भी ज्यादा कंज्यूम करते. Otherwise friction will be more. If the tires are not fully inflated, there will be more friction, and to overcome that friction, your vehicle engine has to spend more energy. To drag it with the same speed, it has to spend more energy, and more fuel will be consumed otherwise. अगर आपके टायर्स फुली इंफ्लेटेड हैं, तो दे विल हेल्प इन सेविंग फ्यूल बिकॉज फ्रिक्शन विल बी लेस. their shape will be properly circular, and the rolling friction will be there. Proper rolling friction will be there, which will be very less. So the engine has to work very less in overcoming friction.
My body is not required to extract the force.
वो फिर उसकी शेप मे बी सर्कुलर नहीं रहेगी, वो डिस्टॉर्ट हो जाएगी शेप, तो वो थोड़ा सा फ्लैट होना शुरू हो जाएंगे. अगर आप उसको फुल ज्यादा ही ओवर इन्फ्लेट कर देते हो तो वो टायर थोड़े फ्लैटन हो जाएंगे, अगेन स्लाइडिंग फ्रिक्शन ज्यादा हो जाएगा, रोलिंग कम हो जाएगा. हाँ जी, वाई We are to speak in context of friction. Okay? हमें फ्रिक्शन से रिलेट करना, ये सोलर से नहीं करेंगे. So speak in that too. Clear? Is that okay? Write one more question now. Yes? जाओ. I thought you are asking a question, so जाओ. Not related to study. It's not related to study. Chalo likho a question. Usko kya kehte hain? Table fan. Yes, likho. A table fan is placed on a board. On a sailboat. A table fan is placed on a sailboat. Question is, will the boat move if the air of fan falls on the sail? Yes, very good, very good. So, if air of the fan falls on the sail of boat, will the boat move? सेल नहीं पता क्या, वो जो क्लॉथ अटैच होता है ना बोर्ड के साथ, एक क्लॉथ लगा होता है सेल बोर्ड, ये आप लोअर क्लासेस में बनाते हो गए, ये सेल थी ना ये वाली. तो अगर फैन की एयर इसके ऊपर पड़ रही है तो क्या बोर्ड मूव करेगी? नो, इट वॉन्ट मूव बिकॉज इट विल बी इंटरनल फोर्स अलोन. फॉलिंग ऑफ एयर ऑन द फैन केप्ट इन द सेम बोर्ड, दैट विल बी एन इंटरनल फोर्स. In turn, sailboat will also exert some force, but since they are being exerted on the same object, motion will not be caused. एक ही बोट के ऊपर दो फोर्सेस लग रहे हैं, इंटरनल फोर्सेस. तो सेल तो बोट का ही पार्ट है, मूव तो सिर्फ बोट ही कर सकती, सेल अकेली थोड़ी चली जाएगी अब, है ना? तो आप ये लिखोगे बिकॉज दिस विल बी एन इंटरनल फोर्स एंड इंटरनल फोर्सेज नेवर प्रोड्यूस मोशन. Internal forces never produce motion. Now write the second part of this question. Write the second part of this question. Now the table fan is kept in another boat. Table fan is kept in another boat and air is falling on the sail of first boat. Will the boat move now?
Yes.
Yes, now the boat will move. क्योंकि आप उसके ऊपर external force act कर रहे हैं. दूसरी boat की air उसके ऊपर fall कर रही है. तो वो external force है. It will cause the motion. और you can also say there are two different objects now. एक एक पे force लगाएगा, दूसरा दूसरे पे लगाएगा. अब दोनों की motion हो सकती है. ठीक है? तो question is, now the fan is kept in another boat and the air of fan is falling on sail of first boat. Air of fan kept in boat 2 is falling on sail of boat 1. Will boat 1 move? Our question is, will boat 1 move? So answer is yes, now it will move because the air of a fan kept in another boat is an external thing. And external forces can cause motion. ठीक है? राइट अनदर क्वेश्चन. कोई डाउट यहां तक? You are sitting inside a car. You are sitting inside a car and pushing the car very hard from inside. Pushing the car very hard from inside. Will the car move? अंदर बैठे बैठे जितने मर्जी धक्के मार लो कार चलेगी क्या? नहीं चलेगी. इंटरनल फोर्सेस कांट प्रोड्यूस मोशन. आप अंदर बैठे बैठे जितना मर्जी उसको धक्के मार दो वो कार मूव नहीं करेगी. बाहर से अगर आप उसको पुश करोगे देन द कार विल मूव बिकॉज दैट विल बी एक्सटर्नल. सो इज दैट कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर नाउ? एक्शन एंड रिएक्शन फोर्सेस आर इंटरनल फोर्स. They can produce motion only if they are acting on two different objects. ठीक है? अगर same object के ऊपर internal forces act कर रहे हैं, then they will not be producing any motion. Is that fine? Clear? चलिए. उस दिन अंशिया ने question पूछा था, वही लिखिए. What is the direction of force of friction on front and back wheel of a bicycle? Bicycle ke two wheels hote. What is the direction of friction on front wheel and back wheel? Dono mein direction different hogi friction. Actually when we pedal the cycle then back wheel move. Us pedaling ka effect back wheel pe hota hai. Front to aise hi hota hai. जो हम पैडल करते हैं उसका इफेक्ट बैक व्हील पे पड़ता है. तो इसका मतलब वो जो बैक व्हील है दैट पुशेस द ग्राउंड बैकवर्ड और इन टर्न उसको रिएक्शन मिलती है फॉरवर्ड. सो व्हाट इज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ फ्रिक्शन ऑन द बैक व्हील? फॉरवर्ड डायरेक्शन. तो बैक व्हील के लिए फ्रिक्शन की डायरेक्शन फॉरवर्ड है. अब जो फ्रंट व्हील है वो तो आगे जा रहा है उसके लिए फ्रिक्शन बैकवर्ड होगा. व्हाट दिस question is what is the direction of friction on front and back wheel of a bicycle? So what you will write? Actually jo cycle move karta hai wo kiske effect ke karke move karta hai? Wo back wheel ke karke move karta hai in the real sense if you see. ठीक है, ये फ्रंट व्हील है एंड दिस इज बैक व्हील. तो ये अर्थ को बैकवर्ड डायरेक्शन में पुश करता है फोर्स लगाता है इसके ऊपर एक्शन फोर्स एंड इन टर्न इट गेट्स अ फ्रिक्शनल फोर्स इन द फॉरवर्ड डायरेक्शन दैट हेल्प्स अस हेल्प्स इट टू मूव फॉरवर्ड. जो फ्रंट व्हील है वो तो आगे जा रहा है इसकी मोशन आगे हो रही है तो इसको फ्रिक्शन मिल रहा है बैकवर्ड डायरेक्शन. So this is the direction of friction on the front wheel. This is the direction of friction on the front wheel and back. Now is that clear? Okay, any doubt now from your side? Now we will start revising the things. Okay, complete your copies now and send me the copy tomorrow by all means. Complete copy with exercise. Have you got your copy checked except for the exercise? Top with exercise with you. If it is ready today, send it today. Otherwise, by tomorrow. After that, I won't do it. Fourth chapter.